So let's start.
Let's start. Okay, we are 410 people.
Yes. So,
how you want me to run the demo?
So first, bonjour à tous. Hello everybody. My name is Julie. I'm in charge of all partnership for La Maison de la Crème Elevire. And it's a great pleasure to welcome you, Karine, today as a special guest. Thank you for welcoming us in your kitchen in Dubai and do it together, the recipe of the French flan. So don't hesitate, all of you, to ask questions on the feed. Karim and I will answer it as best as possible. I let you the speech, chef. So
we have here the cream, the milk, sorry, full fat milk, and we have cream 35% fat content. And of course, we need the butter from Elevire Beurre Gourmand, unsalted butter, 82% fat content. Okay? So these three ingredients to make the flan. Okay?
Perfect.
Super. So just to gain a little bit more time, what I've done yesterday is I prepared the dough, which is, we call it in French, pâte brisée, or pie dough. This pâte brisée is composed from butter and salt, a little bit of sugar, flour. So we put everything in the mixer using the paddle attachment. Okay, this one. So we put the flour, the butter, cold butter, not soft butter. So we take it from the fridge, you cut it in small cubes, and you mix with the salt and the sugar to make sablage. How would you say sablage in English, Julie?
I don't know, I say sablage too.
maybe something like crumble
yes, texture. Exactly, yes. Okay?
And then after that, when we got the crumble texture, we add the cream, we add the milk and the egg yolks. And the recipe has been shared on Instagram last night, so you can refer back to my last post on Instagram and you'll see the recipe in detail. So we have flour, butter, salt, and sugar. With the paddle attachment, we just mix to make sablage, crumble, and then we add the liquid on the top and you mix only for a few seconds. That's it. Why? Because if we mix too much, we're going to develop gluten and your dough will be so hard and you will lose the crunchiness. This is very important. Okay? So, I have done the dough last night because unfortunately I cannot make the dough because the dough is very simple. I just explained. And we roll it out between two parchment paper to 3 millimeter, the thickness. I will show you now. I will take it from the fridge. Because this dough is very rich in butter. If I will do it now, I can't work immediately. I can't work immediately with my dough because it will be so soft. So we need to do it one day before and put it overnight in the fridge. Okay? So I'm gonna now bring my dough and I will show you how we make the fonçage. Fonçage, it means how we apply the dough in the mold. By the way, we have here one mold, 16 centimeter, the diameter, with 5 centimeter high. Okay?
Okay.
This is very important for the flan to have 5 centimeter height because you need to have basically this. You need to have this beautiful texture. Look, you see?
Perfect.
Okay, so if you don't have this height, you won't have the nice mash or the nice texture when you bite in the flan. So it's very important not to take a small ring. You need to have minimum 4.5 to 5 centimeters.
So, and Karim, did you try this recipe with puff pastry?
Yes. So many people ask me, okay, we mentioned last night that this is the eggless French flan. We're talking about the mixture. Now, of course, in the dough, we have egg yolks. But you can replace the dough and you can make it puff pastry. Or even if you can make it with brioche feuilleté also, laminated brioche. Or with pâte levée feuilleté, it works very well. No problem. Okay?
Okay.
So bear with me just a few seconds. I'm going to bring the dough and I will show you how we make the fonçage.
And just for French people online, I will tell you the recipe in French.
Yes.
Vous devez procéder à un premier mélange avec le beurre ramolli, le sel et le sucre. Ensuite, ajoutez les jaunes d'œufs et le lait. Attention à ne pas monter l'appareil. Et dès que le mélange est homogène, ajoutez la farine et mélangez très brièvement pour justement pas donner de corps à la pâte et développer le réseau de gluten. Et ensuite, placez au frigo.
So, we've got this one here. So you see, I laminate, I roll out the dough between two plastic sheets. Okay? But you can use also parchment paper, right? It's not obligatory to use plastic sheet. But me, I like to work with plastic sheet because plastic sheet, you can see what's going on in terms of thickness. You can control more your thickness when you roll it out. So basically, we put the dough between two plastic sheets and then we just roll it out. You can shoot here. You roll it out like this to have 3 millimeter. And like this, you have 3 millimeter. Very important, the dough has to be cold.
And just Karim, just to confirm, the butter has to be cold or like a pomade?
No, it has to be cold. If you use cold butter from the fridge, so basically, this is the butter, right? You mm-hmm. take it from the fridge and you cut small cubes. And then you have better crumble when you mix with the flour.
Okay.
If it's too soft, your flour will turn into paste.
Okay.
Will not be crumble anymore.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. It's a very important question also.
Yeah, because we have question about that. So the butter has to be cold or le beurre doit être froid pour faire justement cette pâte brisée.
Voilà. Donc la pâte brisée, voilà, regardez. Elle est à 3 mm. Oh, sorry, I speak in French. It's a 3 mm dough, you see. Okay. Cold, nice. So I'm going now. Okay, the recipe that we shared yesterday on Instagram, it's for two flans. You can make two flans for this recipe. So we have the mold. Very important also to use flexipon, to put flexipon on the tray, to have nice cooking process from the bottom and to have nice golden color. I'm going to take my dough, and before that, we just apply a very thin layer of butter.
We don't see Karim, yes.
You see now?
Yes, it's okay.
Okay. So we put a little bit of butter inside the dough, inside the mold, just to make sure that when we unmold the flan, the mold will go easy, and then you have nice color from the side, okay?
Okay.
So here, just can show them the process here. Yep. So we take the dough and then we put inside the mold, just gently like this, as you can see. So we do the base before, okay?
Okay. And if we don't have at home a steel pot, we can have to put up some flour on the.
You can simply the best thing is to put parchment paper.
Okay.
In feuille cuisson. That's it. Okay. I'm going now to bring the dough again. So just 1 second. So I have prepared all my dough.
Donc pour ceux qui parlent français, vous devez dans la pâte, la recette donnée hier était pour deux pâtes pour deux flans. Et on découpe du coup des diamètres de 18 cm pour justement mettre au fond d'un cercle préalablement beurré. Et si vous voilà. N'avez pas de feuille style pâte en silicone, vous prenez un papier cuisson très simple pour éviter que ça accroche.
Cut strips like this. I'm going now to apply my strips inside the mold like that.
And okay. The size, Karim, you the size of the strip?
The size it should be a little bit higher from the mold, and then later I will cut to have the same size of the mold. It should be the same size of the mold.
Okay.
But me, at the beginning, I start with a little bit higher, and then when you cut, you have clean edges.
Okay.
It's like when you make tartelette, huh? The same process.
Okay.
And then we continue now. So there is no problem if you don't have one strips enough from the beginning to the end. You can just do like what I'm doing. You can attach two together, and while cooking, it will be sealed. Okay. Voilà. So make sure you push very well. to have nice. Voilà. Now, this one is for the second flan, as I told you. Huh? So we can use it later. If you don't want to make flan, you can make also, you can use this dough for quiche. You can make savory tart, savory pie. It works very well.
Okay. No waste.
No waste. So now I take the knife and I cut the top of the mold or the excess of the dough.
And exactly, the l'épaisseur de la pâte est bien de 3 mm, c'est ça, Karim? Hein?
Ouais, 3
ça millimeters.
Peut, 3 mm, so 3.5, it's okay. I don't like to make it too much thin, because if it's too thin, basically you don't have nice balance between the dough and the cream. So
yes,
it's not like a tartelette, because tartelette usually we do it 2, 2.5. Here it's more 3.5, 3, 3.5. So you have more 1 millimeter, huh? Easy.
Yes. And I have a question. We can, you can find the whole video on IGTV, on Elevir, and also Karim, Karim Instagram after the demo. So if so you just arrive now, we'll see the whole video next.
There we go. Very easy. It's not complicated. It can be done at home. Just 5 minutes, done.
Perfect. Okay?
So we have nice shape. It's very important at this stage is to just make sure that your dough is cold. So I'm going to put it a little bit in the freezer, and then we can talk later about the cream. I will be back in just 1 minute.
I have a question about the tall of the mold.
Okay. You mean the hauteur, the height?
Yes, la hauteur, yes. La hauteur du moule, ouais.
La hauteur du moule, c'est 5 centimètres. 5 centimètres.
5 centimètres and 5 centimètres. Pour la hauteur du moule.
Yes, 5 centimeters. Okay, so now, Julie, I'm going to explain to you a little bit something. We're going to do the things opposite. So because the cream, I will explain a little bit. The cream has to be done before and cool down. So
okay.
And the flan takes 1 hour in the oven. So I'm going to now put the cream inside the mold that we make now today and put it in the oven. Later, while it's cooking in the oven, I will demonstrate how we make the cream.
Okay.
You got it?
You got it. Perfect.
Okay.
Okay.
So we're going to do things opposite. So the cream has been done, of course, in the morning. So it cools down very well. Don't worry, I'm going to show you how we make the cream later on. Just I want to pour it now and prepare my oven.
Et j'ai une question sur le diamètre. C'est un moule de diamètre 18.
Oui. Exactly.
18 centimètres.
So we preheat the oven, Julie. I have
yes.
preheated my oven to 170 degrees Celsius.
Okay.
And the time the oven is ready, I'm gonna pour the cream inside the mold and put the flan in the oven. And then it takes minimum 60 minutes, 1 hour of baking.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
So the time it's in the oven, we're gonna talk a lot about the cream because there is a lot of trick in the cream, because so many of my friend chef has been tried to do the flan at home or in the laboratory, and they had a problem, and I will discuss a little bit about this problem. It's a common problem, basically. It's very important to discuss about this problem, and I will show you and I will tell you all the tricks.
Okay, perfect.
Okay, meanwhile, today we got a nice gift. Flan without vanilla doesn't work, so we need vanilla.
And you need no vanilla.
And the best vanilla, of course, for me, I'm in love with vanilla of Madagascar. I like vanilla of Madagascar. And we've got a new brand in the group of Savencia. It's called Nori. And we've got the vanilla today, express delivery in this confinement, in this quarantine from Zainab. I want to say thanks to Zainab. Zainab, she's responsible of Valrhona in Dubai, in the Middle East. So she sent me the vanilla to save my life, to make the flan for you guys. Okay?
And so, we have a question about the oven. The temperature is 170 degrees. That's it?
Yes. Yes.
170 degrees.
Exactly. We preheat to 170, and then I will show you later. So meanwhile, just to wait a little bit about the flan to set a little bit in the mold, I'm going now to start the infusion. So by cutting the vanilla like this, you can go closer. Voilà, we remove the vanilla seeds. We don't keep anything inside. Nothing. It's a caviar.
It's kind of caviar. Yes.
Pastry chef. Mm. Okay. Very expensive, hein?
Okay. Et Karim, j'ai une question en français. Est-ce que tu mets l'appareil à flanc dans la pâte au frais avant de le mettre au four pour éviter que ça coule?
Exactement. So we cool down the dough. My son, so it's the first time for him. It's a new job for him. So
it's Gaston. Hello, Gaston.
Yeah, exactly. So we put the dough in the fridge to set the dough to make it cold, and then of course the cream has not to be hot. It has to be at room temperature, let's say 35-30 degrees, and then this is the right time to put inside and put in the oven.
Okay, it's clear.
We continue. Don't hesitate, guys. If you have questions, feel free.
And why do you think the flan is really up to date today, and everybody wants to do a flan and eat flan? And
because first of all, flan reminds you of your childhood. When we were a child, we were all eating flan. Me, my first dessert, I remember it was éclair chocolat and flan pâtissier. So it brings you back to your childhood. That's why everybody loves flan. And also, it's very easy to make, and it can be eaten all the time. It can be eaten morning, snack, brunch. You know, it's very easy to eat, very easy for transportation. It's not so complicated to make. So for me, that's why I think the flan become trend today.
Okay. And you do the recipe all over the world in your classes, right?
Yes, it's very well demanded. It's people, they ask for the flan. Everywhere I go, they ask for the flan, and I do the recipe almost everywhere. Okay, so we have here the vanilla. We put all the vanilla inside, and we start the infusion. Okay. What's mean infusion? We have two kinds of infusion. We have hot infusion, and we have cold infusion. When I say cold infusion, it's you have to mix the vanilla and cream and leave it minimum 12 hours in the fridge. Which is really good for the flan. Okay. So if you have time, do it overnight. Leave it in the fridge, and the second day you boil.
Okay. Just for French people, pour les Français qui sont en ligne, il faut infuser la vanille pendant au moins 3 heures sur une infusion à froid, donc 3 heures minimum ou une nuit au frigo, pour justement avoir un bon goût de vanille dans l'appareil, et le lendemain vous le mettez à cuire.
What I'm going to do now is I'm going to keep the vanilla inside, just mix a little bit, and I will keep the vanilla. It will infuse automatically now. The time we make the flan, we put in the oven, I will come back to my cream.
Okay. And we have a question, Karim. Could we use a cream with less fat, a cream with 30% of fat?
Yes, you can do that. You can do that, but I like to use 35% fat because we'll be more rich. And you will have better richness, and the texture won't be the same. Of course, okay. You can use 30%, 25%. When I go to USA, I use cream 40%, because as you know, in USA, they don't have 35%. So it's higher in fat. So it works, but for me, the texture won't be the same. So ideally, 35 is the best.
Okay.
Okay. So this is the texture of the cream, guys, as you can see here. So this has been done like 3-4 hours before. I went to my daily walk. I'm walking in the parking these days to make some exercise, because I need to burn all the calories, you know. So we are not allowed to go outside, you know. In Dubai, it's locked down 24 hours. So okay, you see the texture. The texture looks like bechamel. Ooh. And we don't have eggs here, guys. It's eggless 100%. Okay.
Sans œufs à 100%. Just crème, lait.
So as you can see here, the dough is cold. You see, it's cold. I can see it. It's really cold. So I'm going to now put the appareil flan. Everybody can see now?
Voilà. Yes, it's okay.
The flan inside the dough. Of course, it's not hot. Huh? I repeat again. It's not hot. Voilà. Like this, we flat it to make sure that we have excellent
Et pour l'infusion, vous pouvez faire 3 heures ou toute une nuit, mais le mieux c'est la nuit, comme ça a bien le temps d'infuser. Mais au bout de 3 heures,
voilà,
c'est très bon également.
I really recommend overnight. Really, yeah? It's better.
But the chef recommends all the night. Le chef recommande toute une nuit pour un meilleur résultat.
Come to me. I show you my little guy here, my little son. He will taste because he always, I call him Mr. Taster. He always gives me his approval. Come.
Hello.
You say hi.
Hi. And so nous avons une question en français. Pourquoi ne pas pré-cuire la pâte?
Pourquoi non?
Ne pas pré-cuire la pâte, ne pas la mettre
It's not very important at all. It's not important because, you know, it's a long process of baking. We're going to put it in the oven for 1 hour, 70 minutes. So the dough will be cooked perfectly. You will see later. So, what do you think? You can tell the people here?
Good.
Good? No. Excellent. Yes, very good.
Okay. Et pour la réponse en français, donc pas besoin de pré-cuire la pâte puisque c'est une cuisson longue de 1 heure au four, donc la texture et la cuisson de la pâte seront parfaites.
It's a long cooking process and low temperature. I will just tell you now when I put it in the oven. So we just take a spoon, we flat. As you can see, I didn't put full, huh? It's a 2/3, huh? Because this flour will rise in the oven, huh? Okay? You hear me, guys?
Yes, we hear you.
Okay. Voilà. So this is perfect. So I always keep like 1 centimeter. Huh? I don't put dough. 1 centimeter, I keep it like this. Huh? Very important.
Okay. And for the question, you will have all the recipe on our stories before next the live in French and also in English. So
yes.
Don't worry.
Yes, voilà. So now it's the right time to put it in the oven. My oven is ready. So I said I'm going to do the things opposite. I will put this in the oven because it takes 1 hour. So the time will cook the cream and I discuss about the trick in the cream. The flour will be ready and I will show you the result and then we can taste together. Okay?
Okay.
Super.
Perfect.
So I will take the flour now. Oh. And we go for 1 hour.
And Karim, I have a question. Do you plan to do a book, a pastry book, with your recipe?
Not yet, sir. For now, not yet. It's, you know, if you want to do a book, it's a long sacrifice of time. And the last 3-4 years, I've got really busy with my trips and I didn't have time for the book. Because if you want to focus on the book, really, you need time. You need time for the shooting. You need time for the text. You need time for everything. So hopefully in the future, we can do something. And I'm planning to do ebook because ebook now it's more easy to access and it's much better in terms of technology because everybody can access from the phone today. Anything
share,
you can do, interact it from the phone.
Okay.
Okay. We go back to the cream now. So the flour is in the oven. I have put 1 hour, 160 degrees, and it should be ready.
Okay.
Okay? So we preheat to 170, but when we put the flour inside, we put it back 160.
Okay.
Super.
Just to be clear, in French, we put the four est à 170 degrés et une fois qu'on l'a ouvert et mis la cuisson, enfin le flan au four, on baisse la chaleur à 160 degrés.
And I'm going to tease you a little bit, guys. I will just try the flan that I made today morning.
You have a hello from Colombia.
Oh, Colombia, jamais été. I never been in Colombia. Hopefully one day. Okay. So now here we put inside the bowl cornstarch or poudre à crème. Both can work, castor powder with flour. We mix together the dry ingredients, okay? And then I will add a little bit from the infusion on the top like this. And we mix.
Just to be clear for the public, we start the recipe of the vanilla custard cream. with eggless. Infusion. Yes, eggless.
Voilà, we mix very well. And now I put the rest back for the boiling. Okay.
And you have also hello from Tunisia and Canada, all over the world is connected. Argentina.
Wow, that's very good. They have the best meat in the world, Argentina. Amazing. Okay.
Big family.
We mix very well to make sure that we dissolve the starch and the flour. Okay, guys?
Okay.
Okay, very important trick now is the sugar is still here. Outside. We don't mix the sugar here like pastry cream. We don't do that. I will explain. If you mix the sugar now and you cook like a pastry cream, the sugar in the pan, basically your mixture will become more liquid because your sugar will turn into liquid while cooking. So your mixture will be so soft and so liquid. And when you bake the flan, when you bake the flan inside the oven, your cream won't set.
Okay.
You can see here? You can see the texture of the flan here? The flan is set, you see? Look, it's jiggling, but it's set. If you put the sugar inside the pan and you boil like pastry cream, okay? And you pour the mixture in the dough like what I did before and you bake, it won't set. It will be like volcano in the oven. So basically the mixture will drop out from the mold.
Okay.
Will be liquid. So this is the first trick, very important.
Karim, you could you tell this in French, please, for people from
yes.
France, from France and Algeria.
Voilà, pour l'appareil à flan sans œufs, ce qu'on fait ici, c'est que si je mets le sucre à blanchir ou bien à fondre avec la poudre à crème et la farine, et ce qui va se passer pendant la cuisson, votre mélange, il sera liquide. Et quand vous cuisez le flan dans le four, votre flan, il ne sera pas stable et vous n'aurez pas quelque chose qui est crémeux. Il sera liquide et il ne va pas tenir. Donc, c'est très important de laisser le sucre à côté. On ne touche pas maintenant.
OK.
Donc, on va faire une sorte de béchamel sans sucre.
OK.
Super.
Donc, le sucre à la fin, the sugar at the end.
The sugar, we add it at the end after we cook for 2 minutes like pastry cream. We take it out from the heat and then we add the sugar.
Okay.
Super.
Donc pour en français, on chauffe le lait et la crème avec la farine infusée. On ajoute la poudre à crème et la farine. On laisse et après, une fois hors du feu, on ajoute le sucre pour justement avoir une cuisson crémeuse et pas un appareil à flan liquide une fois la cuisson terminée.
I want to talk a little bit about the vanilla. Focus. I want to talk a little bit about the vanilla. The vanilla, we don't waste vanilla. Never. Okay?
Okay.
We don't waste vanilla, never. The vanilla that we use in the infusion, this has been used for the first flan that I made today. So what you will do is you just rinse them with water after you use them, of course. And then you dry them in a hot place and they will become like a stick, you see? Crunchy stick.
Okay.
This one can be used in multifunctional thing like praline, like you can put it in the sugar bowl and your sugar will be flavored with vanilla. We don't put this in the garbage, never.
Okay. And I have a question. Could you not use flour and add 100% of poudre à crème?
Could you not use flan?
A person wants to use only poudre à crème and not
yes,
flour
yes.
and poudre à crème. It's possible?
Ah, so you want to make it gluten-free?
Yes.
Honestly, I have never tried, but it can work. I'm sure it can work. Just you need to find the right calibration to make sure that his flan is set very well and it doesn't be melted in the oven after he bake. But I'm sure it will work. I'm sure.
Ok. Donc pour la question en français, donc ça, le chef n'a jamais essayé, mais ça marche avec certitude et le but c'est d'avoir une recette qui soit free en gluten. Donc oui, à essayer, il n'y a pas de souci.
Donc c'est juste une question de, il faut trouver le bon dosage.
Ouais.
Après c'est with a bit of cold milk. We mix together. mix very well. Huh?
And we can switch poudre à crème with maizena?
Definitely, it will. In the recipe, it's written cornstarch, so it means maizena. Okay. But me, I put poudre à crème because poudre à crème, it has more aromatic flavor, but okay. Definitely both will work.
Okay, so you can use maizena, vous pouvez utiliser la maizena ou de la poudre à crème.
Voilà. Going.
La poudre à crème a un petit goût un peu plus prononcé que de la maizena.
Exactement. Voilà. We take all the vanilla here. We sift everything. I take my spatula. I bring everything down to the bowl. Very important to sift. Hein? It's more safe.
And the temperature of the boil, you.
We simmer. We simmer like. The temperature is like almost 90-95 degrees. Hein?
Okay.
Boiling.
Okay, it's boiling. Voilà. Donc c'est vraiment à bouillir, donc 90-95 degrés.
Exactly. So I repeat again, the sugar is still outside. Huh?
And the poudre à crème in English, it's custard powder.
Custard powder, yes. Okay, I take back my pan now.
And the quantity is 110 grams for the cornstarch or the custard powder.
Now, we need to cook this one like pastry cream. I'm sure everybody knows how to do pastry cream. Huh? Voilà. So we take the whisk now. There we go, like this. And we go to cook the pastry cream. We need to cook for a good 2 to 3 minutes, guys. Huh? Why? Because if you don't cook your starch, basically your flan will be tasting like very starchy aftertaste. Huh? It's not good. Huh?
Donc vous devez bien cuire l'appareil pour ne pas avoir ce goût justement poudreux, farineux de la poudre à crème ou de la maïzena. Donc la cuisson est très importante pour enlever le goût un peu de farine.
Voilà, comme une crème pâtissière en fait. Regardez.
Like a custard cream.
Voilà, il faut que ça boue. Hein. It has to bubble. Hein.
Et pour juste un récap des ingrédients en français, donc tu as utilisé 1 litre de lait entier, 1 litre de crème excellence, donc une crème à 35%, 110 g de poudre à crème ou maïzena, 16 g de farine C45, 350 g de sucre et 2 gousses de vanille.
C'est 15 g de farine, Julie, c'est ça, 15 g?
Oui, 15 g de farine C45, oui.
Voilà. Alors, et ça marche aussi. Alors, ça, c'est une question qu'on reçoit tout le temps pendant les masterclass. C'est quoi la différence entre une farine 45 et 55? La farine 45, elle contient plus de gluten. Le taux de protéines, il est plus élevé que la farine 55. Donc, pour moi, les deux, ils marchent. Pour le flan, c'est pas très important, la farine 45. J'ai essayé avec la 55, ça marche très bien.
OK. Et pourquoi combiner farine et maïzena et pas pourquoi le mix? Why you mix flour and
because the right calibration for this recipe, the right calibration, we need the flour to help the flan to set and to have nice consistency. Now I said before, someone asked the question before, if you want to skip the flour, of course you can, but you need to find the right calibration.
Okay. Donc, c'est juste pour avoir la bonne texture et avoir de la consistance sur la pâte et qu'il soit bien homogène. Et par contre, si vous remplacez la farine par uniquement de la maïzena ou de la poudre à crème, il faudra faire des essais pour avoir justement la bonne consistance.
You see here, what I'm doing is I'm cooking like crème pâtissière. Hein? Very important to really take your time. And you have to mix all the time because if you don't mix, it will burn. Huh?
Can I have a question? Can you use vanilla extract instead of vanilla bean, vanilla pod?
Yes, you can use vanilla extract, but it's not going to be rich in terms of aroma like vanilla beans. Huh? Big difference.
Okay.
Voilà, let's see if it's bubbling now. So you see, look at the bubbles, guys. You can see the bubbles here?
Yes. Lovely.
Voilà. So now this is the right sign. Let's go back there. This is the right sign that my cream is cooked. So I'm going to take it here, and then I will mix.
And the fire you put at which level the fire?
If you mix very well without stopping, like what I did, I go maximum, because if you coagulate your pastry cream in high heat, it's much better, because the coagulation doesn't take too much time, because if it takes too much time, you evaporate humidity and then okay. you lose a lot of humidity. So that's why I coagulate at high temperature, the maximum. But you need to keep stirring all the time like this.
Okay. Donc c'est important de cuire à une vitesse, une chaleur qui soit forte pour justement éviter l'évaporation et bien garder l'humidité dans la crème.
Voilà, de garder l'humidité dans la crème, c'est très important. Okay, now, this is the right moment to add the sugar, guys, here.
Et pour les ingrédients, okay. j'ai des retardataires sur la poudre à crème, enfin sur la crème vanille pour le flan. Donc c'est 1 litre de lait entier, 1 litre de crème excellence, 110 g de poudre à crème ou de maïzena, 15 g de farine, peu importe T45 ou T55, 350 g de sucre qu'on ajoute à la fin de la cuisson et 2 gousses de vanille.
Waouh, Julie, tu es très forte.
J'ai une ortie sèche.
Donc, I transfer the cream to the bowl. Why I transfer to the bowl? Because if I keep it in the casserole, it will continue cooking. So I don't want to cook more, and I want to cool it down now. So I don't want to keep it hot. Okay?
Okay.
Well, so now we mix. Just to remove the humidity a little bit. You can see the humidity? Yep. The steam, basically. Yes. We need to cool it down a little bit. Once this steam disappears, then we will add the sugar, and then your appareil à flan will be super safe and very stable when you bake it.
Okay.
Something is happening in the oven now. It's amazing.
The smell could be so good.
Look at the vanilla, as you can zoom, Gaston. Yeah. Look at the vanilla here.
And the quantity is for two or for four flan? Just to, for two flan?
The quantity that you gave Julie, it's for two flan, 18 yes. centimeters.
Yes.
Voilà. Me here, what I have in the bowl, I did half recipe only, because I have done half recipe before and I put the flan in the oven. So the recipe that Julie gave you, it's for two flan.
Okay. Donc c'est bien pour deux flans les ingrédients que je vous ai donnés. Et I have a question to repeat the ingredient in English. You have to use 1 liter of whole milk, 1 liter of excellent cream, 110 g of cornstarch or custard powder, 15 g of flour, 350 g of sugar, and 2 vanilla pods. And the quantity is for 2 flans. Sont pour un flan.
Yes. Okay. I will add the sugar now. Voilà, and now we mix.
I'm sorry, we don't sell yet Elevir custard powder.
No, you can use any castor powder, you can use cornstarch, maizena, any kind of fécule or cornstarch or farine de maïs, any kind of farine de maïs. I have used the castor cream, castor powder that I've bought from Carrefour. It's,
okay.
It's not very important really. Eh? We mix very well to just make sure that the sugar is completely dissolved. Okay, now we need to talk a little bit about how to...
Yes, we can use corn flour or corn starch. It's the same. And for the flour, it's 15 grams of flour. If someone of Elevir on the live, could you put all the ingredients, please? Thank you, the team.
So I use the... normal cornstarch, or you can use maizena, you can use also poudre à crème, whatever you want. It works very well. So now I remove the plastic. You see me, I put plastic just because I don't want to make things dirty. It's very easy like this. And I clean my bowl up. So as you can see, the color and the texture is like crème pâtissière, huh? Almost like crème pâtissière. This is now very hot. You see, it's almost, we have steam coming out. So we cannot bake it now. It's impossible.
Okay.
We need to cool it down. So ideally, me, if I'm in the master class, I cool it down on the ice. I put some ice and I cool it down in a manual way, manual process.
Okay.
If you have time, just put cling film contact like what I will do now and leave it at room temperature. It will cool down slowly. And if you have shock freezer, because most of the kitchen and the laboratory, they have blast freezer, blast chiller, you just can spread it in a tray, 40 by 60, and put it in the shock freezer just for 2-3 minutes. It will drop down from 100 degrees. It will go down to 20, 15 degrees very quickly. So the best thing is to cool it down. And before, when it's cold, you can bake it like I showed you before.
Okay. Not hot. C'est très, très, très important d'avoir un appareil à flanc qui soit très froid. C'est pour ça que Karim a transvasé de la casserole dans un cul de poule, l'appareil à flanc, pour justement le faire baisser en température. L'idéal, si vous êtes au labo, c'est de le mettre dans une chambre pour vraiment bien le refroidir et que l'appareil arrive à 25-30 degrés maximum.
Alors, look here. This is the cold one, right consistency to bake. And this is the hot one. You see the difference? We have something here more set, more stable. We have something here more liquid. If I put this in the oven now, the flour won't set in 60 minutes and the texture won't be creamy like what I want.
Okay.
So this is also another trick. The first trick is to add the sugar after cooking. The second trick is to cool it down and let it rest. And then once you have this creamy texture, then you can put it inside your mold.
Okay. Donc, dans les petits conseils de Karim, à bien noter, l'important, c'est de ajouter le sucre en fin, après la cuisson, et aussi de bien faire refroidir l'appareil pour avoir justement une texture bien crémeuse avant de l'ajouter dans le fond et dans le moule. Et pour juste rappeler le process en français, j'ai des questions. Il faut bien chauffer les 1 litre de lait de crème avec la gousse de vanille, ajouter ensuite l'amidon et la farine et donner un léger bouillon, donc arriver à 80-90 degrés. Et ensuite, hors du feu, faire refroidir l'appareil dans un cul de poule. Et enfin, ajouter le sucre.
Voilà. Donc là, ce que je vais faire... pardon, I speak in English, French. I want to film the cream in contact, just to avoid that we have dry skin. It's very important also to... Me, I don't have at home blast freezer, guys. So I think, yes, the best way is to put it either in the freezer in something very flat. It will cool down very quickly. But since I don't need it now, I will just let it cool down tranquillement outside without any problem.
Okay. Donc, on filme au contact pour éviter que ça fige trop et d'avoir une texture de crème qui reste bien crémeuse et pas figée. Et on laisse reposer et descendre en température tranquillement.
Et surtout pour éviter les, tu sais, la couche
ouais, là,
qui va figer
ouais.
Sur le dessus, ça va faire des grumeaux après. Donc ouais. Ça, c'est très, c'est pas top.
On n'aime pas les grumeaux.
Voilà, donc ça, c'est le, on va parler maintenant un peu sur des techniques, détails un peu sur le flan. Donc, this is a mat that I use for the flan. You can, of course, use Silpat, you can use parchment paper, you can use whatever you want. Feel free, please, guys. The result will be the same. But because me, I'm looking for something perfect from the bottom, from underneath, so I use the silpa, okay? And the silpa is perforated. So this is that allow the heat to go inside the silpa and cook the dough very well.
And I have a question. Can we add butter in the appareil à flan?
We don't need, no, because we're using 35%. Fat content excellence cream. We have enough richness from the milk and the cream. We don't need, if you put butter, your flan won't be creamy. You see me here?
Yes.
Yes. If you put butter, your flour won't be creamy like we want. So you don't need to put butter in the flour at all.
Okay. Donc pas besoin de beurre, parce qu'on utilise une crème qui a 35% de matière grasse. Donc justement, on a le taux de matière grasse suffisant pour avoir la bonne texture crémeuse du flan.
Voilà. So this is a flan has been done today morning. I bake it 1 hour in the oven. As you can see, the vanilla. Look at this texture. You see how it's set?
Magic.
And look at the dough here, golden brown. So this is for me. I will show you a little bit also something. For me, I show you a little bit the cut. We take the spoon. So you see here, if I go, it's super creamy. And look from inside. It holds the shape.
Magnifique.
And it's really good for snack, for brunch, for the quarantine. Now we are at home. So we have to bake at home. You don't need to buy from outside because anyway, everyone is closed. So you can do your thing at home. Just make sure you. Important also to cook very well.
Okay.
In 15 minutes, the flan will be ready, guys.
Et en so grammes de pistache, quantity of pistache, une flan pistachio. I have a question.
Flan pistachio, it's. Me, I add 10% of pistachio paste at the end of the cooking. So when I finish my cooking of the cream, I add 10% of pistachio paste at the end.
Okay.
Okay.
So, et pour la cuisson au four, on est sur 1 heure. Pour la cuisson au four, on a des questions.
Yes.
Pour la cuisson, 1 hour.
Yes, average. Yeah, average is 60 minutes between, depends your oven. If you have convection oven, it takes 1 hour. But if you have a static oven without fan, it might take a little bit more time. And you need to cook a little bit more higher than 160 degrees because we need to add 20 degrees more from convection to static.
Okay. Sorry. And at home, it could be longer.
Yes. If you have domestic oven, it will be longer. Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Someone asked what kind of oven you're using now. I'm using convection oven from Inox with a fan ventilation. Very well, it worked very well. I'm doing everything from in this oven, even patachou I do in this oven also, so it works very well.
Okay.
You need to know your oven, guys. You need to understand your oven. This is very important. Your oven is you're working with your oven every day, so at one time you will understand more how to calibrate your temperature. So it's not so difficult.
Okay. I have a question about ingredients. Elevir team, could you put all the ingredients in the feed, please?
Yes. The question is for me or for you?
No, we have a question about ingredients. So I asked to my team. My team is online, like Audrey, Claire, etc.
Okay.
Could you put ingredients in comments, please?
We are almost ready. In 15 minutes, I'm going to take it out. If you want to ask some questions, guys, feel free. For the time, we take out the flan from the oven, and then we show the final product. Okay, some people, they ask me why your flan is shiny on the top. Simply because I make caramel. This is not here. I do it in my master class. I do caramel, dry caramel, and then I deglaze with butter, elevir butter, one vanilla beans, and then I put my caramel on the seal pad, not this seal pad, the normal one, or parchment paper. I let my caramel to dry, and then once the caramel is dry, I break it into pieces, and then I put in the RoboCoupe and I mix into powder. And after that, à la fin de la cuisson, at the end of the cooking of the flan, I put the caramel powder on the top, and then I put my flan back in the oven for 5 minutes. What's going to happen is my flan will get caramelized on the top like crème brûlée.
Okay.
And this is really, I like this idea because it's more more gourmet, you know, it gives you more... gourmandise, more flavors, more aroma, especially the vanilla and caramel. It's a very nice association.
Okay.
So this is how I do usually in the class, but at home it's going to be a mess. So, you know, you cannot do caramel and because you need high temperature and the steam will go out in the oven in the house. So, it's not recommended to make it at home.
Okay.
The caramel step, no need. Now, some people, they put the nappage. I don't know what's nappage. It's a neutral glaze on the top just to make it shiny. But for me, a good flan, it has to be eaten at, of course, not hot. It has to be at room temperature. So when you take the flan out from the oven, you let it for 2 hours to set at room temperature, 2-3 hours, and then you remove the mold, okay? And then after 4 hours, you can cut slice and you can eat, because if you cut the flan while it's still hot, it's gonna be a mess.
Okay.
Some people, they ask also from the region, because we are in Dubai here, there is a lot of Arabic people here, they use saffron. Saffron, it's very well known in the region here, from Iran to Saudi Arabia to Qatar, Kuwait, Dubai. So the same recipe, you can substitute the vanilla by saffron, but make sure you put less saffron, because saffron is very strong, especially if you use the right saffron. So don't go with big quantity of saffron. My advice to you, just you go a little bit if you use high quality of saffron, and then you will have the saffron flavor. I used to do it in Kuwait for one customer and they love it a lot.
Okay. Et j'ai une question sur la cuisson. Est-ce que la cuisson est la même avec une pâte feuilletée, avec une base de pâte feuilletée?
Avec la pâte feuilletée, il est préférable de cuire la pâte. Il faut pré-cuire la pâte auparavant. La pâte feuilletée, elle contient plus d'humidité, donc il faut la pré-cuire à l'avance. Et à mi-cuisson, il faut la pré-cuire pendant 20 minutes. Ensuite, on coule l'appareil à flan et on continue à cuire. Comme ça, votre pâte, elle sera plus croustillante. Et vous aurez un nice balance entre la pâte et la crème.
OK.
Pareil pour la pâte feuilletée, pour la pâte à croissant, pâte levée feuilletée. Il faut la pousser, hein, attention, il faut la pousser, bien pousser à l'avance. Et ensuite, vous coulez votre appareil à flan et hop, au four. Et il ne faut pas la pré-cuire, surtout pas. Hein. Pour la pâte levée feuilletée, il ne faut pas la pré-cuire. La pâte feuilletée, oui, mais pas la pâte levée feuilletée.
OK. Et on a une question aussi, on rappelle, c'est bien une recette d'appareil à flan sans œufs. Il y a des œufs dans la pâte, mais l'appareil à flan, il est sans œufs.
Voilà, et si vous voulez avoir un 100% sans œufs, il faut juste remplacer la pâte et vous faites une sorte de pâte crumble qui ne contient pas d'œufs, avec de la fécule de pomme de terre, fécule de maïs, de la farine, du beurre, sel, un peu de sucre, un peu de poudre d'amande et ça marche.
OK.
Vous appelez le jaune d'œuf et vous aurez quelque chose de eggless 100%.
Et j'ai des questions, ça se peut faire un sirop au lieu de la, du caramel sur le flan?
Un sirop, oui.
Badigeonner un sirop, oui.
Il y a des collègues à moi qui glacent avec un sirop à 30, juste pour lustrer un peu le flan, pour donner une brillance. Ouais, ça marche très bien, ça marche, mais je trouve le goût de caramel, il marche très bien avec la vanille. Et okay. It reminds me a little bit of the flan caramel that I used to eat in the plate when I was a child. So, caramel, vanilla, it works very well.
OK. Et some people want to caramelize the paste. It's possible to put sugar around to get...
Yeah, after that, you know, this is all details, you know. If you want to do that, why not? You can just put some caramel powder or icing sugar and you can put back in the oven. But let's not over sophisticated the things, you know. For me, a good flan, it's a good flaky dough, nice and crispy, and good creamy mixture. That's it. Okay. Now, you want to add caramel, you want to caramelize the dough, this is all plus. But for me, let's stick to the base. Let's make a good base and then you will really enjoy a good flan. The recipe that is shared on Elevir website, the recipe that has been done by Nicolas Boussin and his team, for me, this is one of the best flan that I ever had in my life, because, you know, sometimes when you go to Paris, you see the flan everywhere in the display and it's really heavy. Sometimes it's too much yellow in terms of color because there is eggs and egg yolks inside. So when you start biting in the flan, you feel really this heaviness, while this one, when you eat, you eat, and you don't stop because it's very light and it's very creamy.
Creamy. Thank you, Karim. I know you are a big fan of this recipe.
Yes. So, we're almost done. If you can wait more 8 minutes. In 8 minutes, we're going to take the flan. How much pistachio in... I can put, please, 10%, my dear. You can put 10% of pistachio. It works very well.
Do you try the flan of Yann Mengi, Karim?
No, I didn't have the chance to try it, but definitely when I will pass by Paris, I heard a lot about this chef, and I would love to pass by his pastry shop and taste his dessert. Hopefully very soon.
Next November.
Yes. I'm super fan of the pastry in Paris. If you want to talk a little bit about pastry, and every time I go to Paris, when I reach the airport, I get out from the airport, I run immediately to Champs-Élysées, and I go to Pierre Hermé store and in Champs-Élysées, and first thing I do in Paris is one tarte vanilla and one plaisir sucré. This is my first two things in Paris to do. Then after that, we can talk.
Yes. First Pierre Hermé, and after...
We can discuss. We can talk. We can go to... we can see the friends. We can see people. But for me, the best, really, I mean, you know, there is a lot of good pastry chefs in Paris. Michalak, Hermé, Yann Couvreur. So many big names. But for me, really, Pierre Hermé. When I go to Pierre Hermé, I feel really that this guy is doing very simple things, but it's magic in terms of taste. Magic.
It becomes a classic of pastry, like vanilla tart and Isparan.
Exactly. Yeah, it doesn't change too much in his pastry, but you always feel the right balance and the right flavor, right texture. For me, this is what you need in pastry. You don't need to sophisticate things. You need simplicity and efficiency.
And last time you have been to the Fouquet's and taste the tea time of Nicola Pacello, right?
Exactly. We've been with Nicola and the team. We taste amazing tea time of Nicola. And I fell in love with the hazelnut cake of Nicola, hazelnut praliné gâteau de voyage. It's impressive, the flavor. It's bomb atomic. It's very explosive in terms of flavor. And I think he's a very talented guy. And we enjoy also, he made us a tour in the kitchen, and we met the team, and you know, it was really important day and very, very nice.